Oh, it is so hot out. This is stressing me. I didn't even put my notepad to the side. Give me a second. Okay, deep breath. That's a bit better. Alrighty, folks. Well, I was mentioning there that it's hot out. We are at the beginning of August and the temperatures are absolutely cooking outside and almost like on cue to the day, August 1st, and powdery mildew I see showing up in one of the corners of my bed. And powdery mildew is going to hit our zucchinis, our squashes, our cucumbers, potentially melons, and it probably could even get onto some of our tomatoes, even peppers, I've heard with some folks. So it can be really, really damaging. And what I want to be doing today and kind of what I'm curious to figure out is that there are a lot of different kind of home remedies and different mixtures, concoctions that you can put together. And so what I want to do today is run a little test, a little trial. I'm going to test out three of the ones that I've seen a lot of on the internet and try to figure out which one of them works best. So I got no idea where this video is going to go, but we're going to give it a whirl. And we're gonna mix them all up, then we're going to head outside and we're going to apply them. I've even got little stickies for each of the leaves that we're going to apply them to. And then we're gonna check back in a couple days to see how they have each performed. So at the very end of this video here, I'm going to share the one that performed the best and that I'll be using in my garden for the rest of the season here. So to get started, what I want to do is chat through what are the three different types of kind of concoctions or mixtures that we're going to be utilizing. So the first one is going to be based with apple cider vinegar and water. 1 liter of just regular tap water. And then we're going to add 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar. Then we're going to mix that up real well. And then we're going to pour that into a spray bottle that we can spray onto the leaves. And then we're going to put a little name tag on it so we don't forget. The second one is a more alkaline mixture, so that's going to be milk, and we're going to use that with water. And so for mixture number 2, we're going to do 6 parts water, 4 parts milk. So just to keep everything consistent, we're going to do it off of a liter, which means 600 milliliters of water. And then 400 milliliters of milk. And then we're going to give that a good mix. And then we're going to pour that into the next spray bottle. Powdery mildew hates 1% milk. Their nemesis. And then the third one is going to be a combination of a little bit of baking soda and then oil and dish soap mixed with water. Is once again 1 liter of water to get started. And then we're going to grab 1/2 tablespoon of baking soda. And then we're going to do 1/2 tablespoon of canola oil. And then we're going to do 2 drops of dish soap. Mix it up real good. And then we're going to put that into the 3rd spray bottle that we have. So now that we've covered off on all of that, let's head out to the garden and start applying these 3 mixtures to the leaves on our, it's gonna be a spaghetti squash plant. I don't buy milk all that often, so I figured then rather than letting it go to waste, I'd put it to use on some cereal that's about 8 or 9 months old, but still tasting pretty good. So the 3 sprays that we put together here, they are on the leaves on the spaghetti squash out there that were showing early signs of powdery mildew. And what I'm going to do over the course of the next 5 to 7 days is simply observe it. And then at the end of that period, again, it's either gonna be 5 days or 7 days, I'm gonna kind of take note and do a whole bunch of observations, share a whole bunch of the results with you in terms of did any of these work? Did they not work at all and the mildew is continuing to spread? Or did they potentially have a negative impact where the leaves are now beginning to die off? So on, yeah, either day 5, day 7, I'm going to share all of that information with you, and I'm also going to share which one I'm choosing to use for the remainder of the season here. So that's all for right now. In a couple days, we'll check back in and share all that with you. The good news about it being August over here is that all of the blackberries are beginning to ripen. So I'm going to head out here and go and harvest some blackberries for a couple of hours here. Catch you in 5-7 days. Well, folks, it's actually 10 days later here, and I wish that I had some better news for you, but this is where we start getting into the ugly truth of powdery mildew. And so if you look at the plant behind me there, it's definitely looking a little bit worse for the wear. And I actually pulled off leaves for each of the different sprays that we applied, and there is either still powdery mildew on it, or it is just really looking a heck of a lot worse for the wear and all kinds of yellow and brown spots on it. Or it's just a combination of both. It's got powdery mildew, it's looking worse for the wear, so we're not in the greatest position here today. So what I first wanted to touch on is why the leaves are looking so much worse for the wear. And the reason behind that is because what we were doing with each one of those sprays was trying to change the environment that the powdery mildew was living in. So with the apple cider vinegar and the baking soda, we were looking to make a more acidic environment on that leaf so that the powdery mildew wouldn't be able to establish and settle in. And then with the milk spray, we were hoping to make that one and create a more alkaline environment on the leaves so that once again, the powdery mildew would not be able to settle in. However, what that means for the leaf is that its natural state, natural pH, is getting altered to either something more acidic or more alkaline. And that's why we see the yellow spots, the brown spots, all that wear and tear on the leaf. It's no longer in its natural environment. And I would normally be okay with a level of that if it meant that the powdery mildew had completely disappeared or is no longer there, but we're still seeing powdery mildew on all of those leaves and all throughout the plant there. So they weren't incredibly effective in removing the powdery mildew. And for me, this is really what it boils down to with powdery mildew and the ugly truth around it, is that once it has made its way onto its plant, onto the plants, onto the leaves, and started to spread throughout, well, it's gonna be pretty hard to get rid of it. So for myself, powdery mildew, it's much more a game of being as proactive as possible opposed to reactive solutions. And so what we're gonna do next to wrap up this video is I'm gonna share with you my top 3 proactive strategies to slow down and mitigate that onset of powdery mildew. But if this video has been valuable to you in any way, shape, or form, even if it's not the results that you were looking for, because I know it wasn't for me, then go ahead and give us a like, because it helps us get in front of new gardeners that may not have yet experienced gardening's mental health benefits. So my top 3 proactive strategies when it comes to managing powdery mildew first comes at the very beginning of the season, and that is all around spacing. So powdery mildew, it loves a low airflow and humid environment to be living in. And so what that means for us is that we want to be creating airflow. And one of the ways that we can do that is by providing each of the plants with enough space. So let's make sure that our squashes, our zucchinis, our cucumbers, pumpkins, etc., aren't sitting directly on top of each other, but have enough room to grow. Now, the second piece also is on the airflow front, and that comes to pruning. So I really like to kind of prune back anywhere from 25 to 50% of these plants because they grow so prolifically. And again, we want to promote that airflow. And by pruning, we're creating these little channels for air to be flowing through. When we look at this plant here, the powdery mildew, it's set in on that back corner first. And that back corner, it has a wall on 2 sides of it, which would mean absolutely no airflow coming from either of those. So probably in hindsight, not the best place to be planting it. And when it comes to pruning, if I see any early specks or spots of powdery mildew, those would be the leaves that I would be using to take as that kind of 25 to 50% of the plant that I'm pruning off and back. So look for those ones and prune them off straight away so that we get the powdery mildew out of there, because it would continue to travel out. And the third piece, the third kind of tip or strategy, is when it comes to watering, water at the soil of the plant. So again, powdery mildew, it loves that humid environment to be living in. If we water at the soil, then that is going to create less humidity and then again, be a less favorable or desirable environment for the powdery mildew to be living in. So that's everything that I wanted to cover in this video here today. If you've got any strategies or any recipes, any approaches to how you handle powdery mildew in your garden, and if you have great success with them, please, please, please share those in the comments with us, because I'd absolutely love to try a couple of them out and continue to work through this one and find a better approach, better kind of reactive solution in there. So that's everything for today. Hope you're feeling more comfortable, more confident in the garden. Can't wait to catch you on the next one. See you then.